and you follow and you'll get the beating, same beating. It's a miracle. Wallah, it's a miracle that Ahmad Didar has been doing this job for the past 40 years. You know, from 1957, over 40 years. And in 40 years, no non-Muslim has ever touched me like this. Did you know that? And I'm talking the most controversial subjects. In the city hall, 1957, I go to the city hall and the Muslims are shivering. Subject, what the Bible says about Muhammad. Say, how can you talk this? How can you talk about the Bible? They're shitting in their pants, Muslims. I lecture in Cape Town and you're getting diarrhea here. My people are getting diarrhea here. No, julab. Julab yahan sala lagta hai tumko yahan. Sala, I'm lecturing in Cape Town and you're getting julab here. What's going to happen to me that? Look, after 40 years, most controversial subjects, Christ in Islam. Is the Bible God's word? Is Jesus God? Was Christ crucified? Most controversial subjects. In Britain, in America, in throughout the world. And no Christian has ever touched me like this, yet. Nobody has thrown a rotten tomato or a rotten egg at me, yet. I was assaulted once. You know by who? By Muslims. Muslims did it. I was assaulted in Newton Hague. As a guest of the Muslim Youth Movement, I had gone there to lecture there. And I got a beating. Who beat me? Muslims. No Hindu or Christian or Jew has ever touched me, yet. I must be an angel. Or I'm like that man. Says the man they couldn't kill. There was a program on radio. The man they couldn't kill. He seemed to have had got a shield around him. People can't see, but nobody can get near him. That's Ahmad Didat. Alhamdulillah, Allah has looked after me. No, no. I'm not provocative. Wallah. I'm speaking, I'm reasoning, and the guy who's listening, although he disagrees, he can say, well, he's got a right to say what he's saying. You disagree with me, but he says, no, he's not insulted. He's putting forth his case. Said, look, you say Jesus is God, we say he's not God. Why? You say Christ died for your sins, we say, no, he didn't. He said, why? Coming to the point, the sheikh, I showed him this. He said, 100%. Your way of talking, I said, now what you do, I said, it depends on the customer. Bil hikmah. How do you talk to the people? Each according to the customer. We, the Indian Muslims, the business people. When I was a schoolboy, I left school, I went and worked in the country shops, and my fathers, our fathers, elders, were saying, Jiu gharak te upadiku. You know, as the customer is, that's the type of parcel you tie up for him. Jiu gharak te upadiku, depending on the customer. Right? The white man comes along, he buys a brown paper, brown paper. Brown paper, bring brown paper. The poor African buys newspaper, newspaper, we tie it up. Jiu gharak te upadiku. See, depending upon the customer, the parcel that you tie depends upon your customer. Now this guy, poor fellow, he doesn't mind newspaper. We're trying to like the white man, he needs a brown paper, so you need a brown paper. So according to your customer, you tie the parcels. What is he talking about? So start with him. The ordinary man, the fellow worker with you, who's working with you, he's working with you, talk to him nicely. Talk to everybody nicely. Assuming that the guy's good. He says, you know, you start. How do you start? With a Christian. He says, you know, we believe in Jesus. He says, what? We believe in Jesus. He says, what? He's thinking you want to curry favor with him. He says, you know, we believe he's one of the mightiest messengers of God. He says, yeah. He says, yes. He says, you know, we believe that Jesus was born miraculously without any male intervention, which many modern day Christians, including the bishops of the Anglican Church, they don't believe, but we believe. Did you know that? Bishops of the Anglican Church, they don't believe, but we believe. We believe that Jesus was the Messiah, the Messiah, translated Christ. We believe he gave life back to the dead, based on Allah, and he healed those born blind and the lepers, based on Allah. You know what the Quran says? He says, no. Opportunity. Invite him home for a cup of tea. I'm showing you how to do the job. Invite him home for a cup of tea. He says, have you seen the Quran? He says, no. He says, look, I'll show you. You know what it says about Jesus? He says, no. Open. In this one, volume. Index, Jesus, he speaks about Jesus, first item, and the J, Jesus, first item, it says a righteous prophet, a true prophet of God, second item, his birth, chapter 3, verse 42 onwards, chapter 19, verses 23 onwards, open chapter 3, and read it to your Christian friend, your fellow countryman, your fellow worker, take him home, man, for a cup of tea, if you can't afford a dinner,
give him a cup of tea and some bhajas and samosas and see what you can do with that. Wallah, you can perform miracles. Open the book. Chapter 3, Surah Ali Imran. Imran, chapter 3, ayah 42. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wa is qalatil malaikatu ya maryamu. So behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allah astafaki, Allah has chosen thee, wa taharaki, and purified thee, wa astafaki ala nisa'il alameen, chosen thee above the women of all nations. I said, do you know, such an honor is not to be found in Mary, the mother of Jesus, even in your Bible. Did you know that? Did you know that? This honor that the Quran gives Maryam alayhi salam is not to be found in his Bible. Tell him so, it's not even in your Bible. His Holiness the Pope has written a book called Crossing the Threshold of Hope. No Muslim is likely to have this book, I'm telling you. No Muslim can. We are not a reading people. Do you know that? We don't even read newspapers. If you read the newspapers, this hall would be packed. Do you know that? If our people were reading people, they would have read the newspaper. Damn it all, forget the pamphlet. If you read the newspapers, you would have come. Curiosity. Let's see, man, what this guy has to say. Curiosity. You even haven't got curiosity. You don't read newspapers. Bulk of us, I'm telling you, we don't even read newspapers. I see a review of this book in the Daily News. Then I said, what has thy God to say? What will he say? How much is it? You know how much? $59.99. Are you hearing? Are you guys hearing? $59.99. If you gave 60 rands, you get this change, this 1 cent. Can you see this? If you gave 60 rands, you get 1 cent change for that book. 240 pages. In contrast, hardcover, gold embossed, silk paper, 5 rands. I give you 12 of this for one of this. I give you 12 of this for one of this. And the Muslim finds it expensive. He finds it expensive. I'm telling you, this is my nation. You make me angry. Wallah, you make me angry. The 60 rands less 1 cent. I give you 6 Qurans for the price of 60 rands. And 1 cent change I'll give you 2. 1,200 pages, 2,000 each. 6 copies I give you for 60 rands. And 1 cent change I'll give you. I give you 6 Qurans, 2,000 pages each. That's 12,000 pages as against 240 pages. For this one, I give you 12,000 pages and you feel it hard. Can you make 10 rands each? And I say, if you can't afford it, come and see me. I'll give you free. Wallah, free. You just have to come and tell me, uncle. He said, look, I need the Quran, but I can't afford it. I want the book, Mr. Didai, but I can't afford it. Wallah, I won't ask you for your bank balance and I won't ask you how much you're earning and how you squander your money. I'll give it to you free. But that too you can't do. You know that you're too damn proud, man, too damn arrogant. I'm telling you, you are an arrogant people. Somebody offers you something for nothing, even that you can't take. How miserable can you be? How miserable can you get? I want to know. I say, no, to my sisters here, all the grown-ups, I want you to take one each free. That's for you. It's a great sacrifice on your part. Having come, you honored me, wallah, I feel greatly honored. May Allah bless you all. Everybody gets this book. You people, 5 rands each. If you can't afford it, come and see me in the office. This Quran, 10 rands each is available here. Man, you need it. It improves your English, wallah. This English that I'm talking, where did I get? I'm a standard 6 Johnny. But I'm talking, you know where? This Quran, wallah. This Quran did the job for me. It improved my English. Talk, man. Then gives you an opportunity of this. Share the message. Deliver the message. Allow your children to read this. Make your children once a week, at least once a week, your son, your daughter, then they are padhne tari mane hamrao. You know, read it and explain to your mother. Read it and explain to your mother. Once a week, only once a week, don't be too greedy. Only once a week, after supper, ask your son, they say, read it and explain to your mother. You know what you're doing? You're making